Blackman, Michael.
I tell you, he needs to be serious, Coach.
The following tag team contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, at a combined weight of 491 pounds, Al Snow and the lethal weapon, Steve Blackman.
The Rock needs to be serious because The Rock is in serious trouble. It wouldn't surprise me at all. As soon as Raw kicks off on Monday, The Undertaker's out there, Kane's out there, and they want some answers from the Great One.
They are certainly ticked off, and now The Rock is, you know, I got to ask a question, Michael. Is he pissed off the wrong people when you talk about Kane, Undertaker, and also the faction?
Well, you know, it's one thing to have the faction after you, but The Undertaker and Kane,
different story.
Of course they were, right?
The Rock is on the same team. He respects Kane and Undertaker. He said it time and time again.
The Rock only cares about one person, and that is The Rock. Plain and simple.
The one thing he does care about, Michael, is the World Wrestling Federation title, as does Kane, as does The Undertaker. But The Rock wants to go after Triple H. I don't think he cares so much about Kane and Undertaker, but now he is going to have to deal with those guys.
Yes, he's going to have to deal with them. I'm telling you, I bet you the bottom dollar, Kane, The Undertaker, the brothers will be out asking for answers immediately on Raw.
They will waste no time. No, not at all. They will waste no time this Monday on Raw to settle their differences with the Great One, The Rock.
The Rock needs to be concerned about that, not the WWF title, because if I'm The Rock, I say, well, you know, Triple H beat me twice in 3 weeks.
Good point. Well, it's go time. Tag team action. Al Snow, Steve Blackman, D'Lo Brown, and Perry Saturn. And Michael, speaking of Perry Saturn, he's got a big match tomorrow night on Heat. He will go against Devon Dudley, but it's not just any match. It's a King of the Ring qualifying match to get into that round of 16.
Well, we saw a number of qualifying matches this week, including Chris Benoit against the Road Dogg. Some people would say the Dudleys cost the Road Dogg his opportunity to advance.
Well, we know their history between the Dudley boys and the Road Dogg and X-Pac.
Oh, they came so close, the Dudleys, to put Torrey through a table. So
I thought it was going to happen. I thought it was going to happen.
Oh, you want to see it, don't you?
But tomorrow night on Heat, not only does Devon Dudley take on Perry Saturn, but his tag team partner, what a kick by Al Snow. His tag team partner, Bubba Ray Dudley, will go one-on-one against the Big Boss Man. You talk about the physical guys there. What a clothesline by D'Lo Brown.
You want to talk about physicality? What about the main event on Sunday Night Heat?
Wow.
A fatal four-way match for the Intercontinental title. Of course, Chris Benoit is in it, the champion. Hardcore Holly, Y2J, and Val Venus. And what a difference Trish Stratus has made in Val Venus.
That she has. We need to point out a couple of things. Everybody saw this past week on SmackDown, just a couple of days ago, Val Venus taking on Rikishi, trying to get back a little revenge, I guess you will, after Rikishi had given Trish the stink face on Raw. But Val Venus, he took quite a beating.
Val Venus took quite a beating. I mean, you talk about Rikishi at over 400 pounds diving off the stage, some 10 to 12 feet onto Val Venus. It's amazing Val wasn't seriously injured.
Val Venus, a tremendous athlete in tremendous shape. And Michael, Val's got to be very, very upset right now. I got to ask the question, is he going to be able to concentrate on this Intercontinental title match, or is he going to be thinking about revenge on Rikishi?
Well, I can't answer that for you. Only Val could. And, oh, nice leg trip by Al Snow. We've seen this before, and it is just as devastating again. I want to ask you a question. I love Rikishi. Too cool. They're fun to watch. But what is Rikishi thinking? I can think of a million things to do to Trish Stratus, but I would never think about giving her a stink face.
Well, that may have been the longest. Here's a cover by Al Snow. 2-0. Perry Saturn gets the shoulder up. That may have been the longest stink face we've seen to date.
Well, I'll tell you this much. Trish did not appreciate it, and I bet Perry Saturn is not appreciating. Oh! D'Lo!
D'Lo Brown hit Al Snow in the back of the head, and Perry Saturn doubled it up.
That is the way to stop momentum. That is good tag team action.
Oh!
Oh, D'Lo on fire!
Well, you mentioned Trish Stratus. She did indeed interfere in that match. Anytime you slap somebody in the face like she did to Rikishi, good slap by D'Lo Brown. That's grounds for the stink face, Michael.
Well, I'll tell you what it was grounds for is Val Venus doing to Rikishi. Oh! What velocity on that Irish whip by D'Lo. That was grounds for Val to do what he did. Have you ever seen anybody bust Rikishi open? Have you ever seen anybody put Rikishi down like Val Venis did?
Here's a guy by D'Lo Brown, hook of the leg, and a kick out by Al Snow.
Come on, Teddy Long. A little slow on the count there, Teddy.
Well, Michael, we talked about King of the Ring and all the qualifying matches to get to the round of 16. You know, of course, this year is the biggest King of the Ring field ever. 31 men, one woman. But look at some of the potential matchups later on in later rounds.
Well, let's talk about that one woman, Mamacita.
Oh, yeah.
China. What's going to happen if China has to face Eddie further down the line?
That could be interesting.
Then we'll really see.
Heat taking on Mamacita.
We'll see who really wears the pants in that relationship.
And what about, we already talked about, oh, wow, watch that suplex. Here's a cover by Perry Saturn, hook of the leg, two count by Teddy Long, and a kick out by Al Snow. Well, you mentioned Rikishi and Val. They're both into the round of 16. They could potentially meet down the road.
And if they do meet, and I'm not talking about the cheeks of Rikishi's ass, it'll be a hell of a fight.
Oh, yeah. You're talking about Kurt Angle could potentially meet the Intercontinental Champion Chris Benoit. Oh, wow. And Snow.
Great maneuver. We talked about this last week. The King of the Ring. First of all, it is a very high-profile title. It has been a platform for such WWF superstars to launch their career even further. Case in point, Stone Cold Steve Austin. How about Triple H?
Steve Blackman cleaning house. Good point. It really bolts any superstar here in the World Wrestling Federation to a new level if they can indeed win King of the Ring. And Steve Blackman's clearing house. And gosh, he's quick.
He's quick, but he's hitting it air. How stupid is that?
Well, D'Lo Brown nails him from the outside. Now all four men are involved.
Uh-oh. Now there you go.
What a DDT by Lethal Weapon Steve Blackman on Perry Saturn.
Come on, Blackman. Cover him. See, that's a mistake. They're wasting time. Look how long Perry Saturn was on the canvas.
D'Lo Brown right out here in front of us. Oh, and he pulls a rope, and now goes Al Snow.
Good save by D'Lo Brown, and what a tag team match this has turned into.
Well, hell is broken loose.
Roll up.
Here's a roll up by Perry Saturn, too. Oh, and a kick out by Steve Blackman. I don't even know who the legal men are in the ring right now, Michael. Oh.
Do you ever? Do you even pay attention?
That's ever. To it. Perry Saturn barely gets out of it. What a tremendous matchup here on Jakked between these four tremendous athletes.
Tell you what, all of them struggling, trying as hard as they can for a victory.
Here's a two count. Wait a second. Teddy Long, it looked like he counted to three. Now Steve Blackman's up. He doesn't know what's going on.
No, I believe D'Lo pulled Teddy Long out of the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen,
he
the referee has thrown both teams out and rules this a no contest.
Teddy Long said he ain't taking that no more.
He said, I've had enough of this. A double throwout, a no contest, so we have no winner.
No.
D'Lo's not happy.
Perry Saturn's never happy.
Wow, what a strange ending to a very good match. But no winner here between D'Lo, Perry Saturn, and Al Snow and Steve Blackman.
I got a feeling these four men will see each other again.
Michael, very unusual finish. Well, coming up on Jakked, Midian is set to go one-on-one as he tries to overcome the tremendous challenge of Headbanger Mike.
Plus, we will see the daredevil, the high-flying S.A. Rios.
You talk about daredevils, how about Jeff Hardy, Chris Benoit? We'll take a look back at the Intercontinental title match.